During the process of doing this research in Dignity, we've done a variety of different studies. One of the important outcomes was something that we call a model of dignity in the terminally ill. Again, it's an empirical model, so it's not a model that I, along with my colleagues, dreamt up. We went to patients and asked them, what are the things that would impinge on your sense of dignity? What are the things that would reinforce or bolster your sense of dignity? And based on that very detailed inquiry and a very rigorous qualitative methodology that we used, we came up with a model. And this model really points out that there are three primary domains that influence dignity at end of life. One domain has to do with things that are mediated by the illness. One domain has to do with things that are more externally mediated, something that we call the social dignity inventory. So things that can happen in and around the patient. So is their privacy respected? Is it counterbalanced by adequate support? Something called aftermath, not aftermath concerns, but care tenor, the tone of care. Again, that gets back to the healthcare provider, the nuances, the fragrance of care, if you will. And then the other domain is something called the dignity-conserving repertoire. And this really had to do with the psychological and spiritual issues that might inform whether or not somebody's dignity was upheld or not. It has to do with their own sense of self and personhood, their sense of important roles, spiritual life. That model then has served as the basis of various different other initiatives. And one of those initiatives was the development of what we call the PDI, or the Patient Dignity Inventory. We've taken each element of the dignity model and we have said, what question corresponds with each of these elements? So if somebody says, for instance, no longer feeling like the person I was, that is an item that is on the Patient Dignity Inventory. It's kind of the quintessential loss of sense of self. And we were talking about that earlier. The psychology of illness is really the psychology of loss. If I no longer feel that I'm the person I once was, it's a profound end-of-life question. I mean, at what point in time does illness lay claim to so much that what's in jeopardy is personhood? There are many symptom inventories out there, but the thing that perhaps was distinctive about the Patient Dignity Inventory is that it's able to broach questions across those various domains. So some of the questions are certainly in the physical realm. I mean, having uncontrolled pain, you know, not being kept clean, these are things that could be a profound assault to sense of dignity and sense of personhood. For other people, it really is about a spiritual journey, making peace with one's maker. For others, it's about trying to hang on to roles that continue to be meaningful to the very end, a role as mother, father, daughter, husband, wife, and so on. So the Patient Dignity Inventory then turned out to be 25 questions broaching those three primary domains that I explained. And the nice piece about the instrument is that it provides you a snapshot. It gives you a sense, what are the things that might be causing this individual angst or suffering towards the end of life?